Another interesting presentation on the Borromean link is this. I have brought here two loops, blue and pink, and I'll hold them up through my fingers like so. There are three loops here. At the bottom, the blue loop. In the middle, the pink loop. And at the top, the loop consisting of my fingers, the index finger and thumb legs. So one, two, and three. Now, it seems very intuitive that the blue and my finger loops are not linked at all. I mean, they're far apart in space. In contrast, the blue and pink are linked, and pink and my fingers are linked. But then I grab this part and pull, and they exchange places. Huh? This time, the blue, which seemed unlinked to my fingers, is linked to my fingers, but the pink, which used to be on my fingers, is now far away at the bottom, and the pink and blue are still linked. And I can keep doing this. I just grab this part and then pull, and they exchange places. They exchange places. This is very meditative. It's kind of zen. You can keep doing this, and they keep exchanging places. Now, this is a Borromean link, in the sense that these are three loops that are, of course, stuck together. You can't take them apart, as you can see. But if you make any of the three loops disappear, the other two can fly apart. Indeed, if I release my fingers, well, of course, these two can be pulled apart. Next, if you imagine that pink has disappeared, well, blue and my fingers are far apart, so they are unlinked. And finally, if I remove the blue, you can see that had it not been for the blue, I could pull the pink one off my fingers. So any two of these loops are mutually unlinked, but three together are linked, and that is a Borromean link. And this is some operation on the Borromean link, which exchanges two of the loops while keeping the third one fixed. We learn in high school and elsewhere that when you drop any object, you know, this, this, or this, the stuff falls in free fall over a distance which is equal to half gt squared, where t is the time.